As we approach the end of the year, we're going to keep this weather extra on a positive and on a happy note. And it does deal with snow. And considering the weather extra that we did about 2 weeks ago when we were talking about what the long-range forecasts are for snow in the Sierra and the dire predictions for how often we could see low or no snow years, we're going to talk about the way this year has gone so far in the Sierra, because this is a feel-good story. Back on December 5th, which was the highlight for that last weather extra, the snowpack in the Sierra was pretty dire. There really wasn't a whole lot of snow to it. And here's a kind of a unique way of looking at it. The map put together here is actually showing you what the depth of the snowpack is. It's a really great visualization put together from automated sensors throughout the Sierra Nevada and satellite information as well, which can help us paint the picture. It gives us a visual. That was December 5th. You see the scale over here, light blue to dark blue, tells you it's, you know, 12 inches. Maybe there was a foot, foot and a half of snow depth in the Sierra on December 5th. Of course, we know we've had a very busy winter in the Sierra. So just jumping ahead now to December 19th, before this last series of big storms, by December 19th, you can already see there was a huge improvement. And when you look at the colors on the screen and match it up to the scale over here, once you start to get up into these shades of purple and magenta, it says 75 inches on there. The print's pretty small, but if you can't read it, that color corresponds to 75 inches. And I'll do the math for you. 75 inches is about 6.5 feet. That means the snow is as deep as 6.5 feet in the locations where you get into those colors of magenta. And there's a lot of areas in the higher parts of the Sierra where you have that. But this is only one way of measuring the snowpack, and it's not the best. What you really want to know is how much water is being stored in the snowpack, because if the snow's got a lot of air in it, you can have a snowpack that's really high, but if it's mostly air, that doesn't do you any good. You want a snowpack that's got a high concentration of water in it, that's been compacted down, and you really get a sense for how much water is in it. And we can do that reading. I'm going to show you that on this next map. Watch the color scheme change, and the scale over here is going to change because we're switching from how deep is the snow, literally, to how much water content is in it. So let's go to that map now. Color codes changed, the scale changed. And when you look at the map over here, see the colors now on here, now it's a dark blue and purple, and the scale over here, once you get into the purple, you can see it says 18 inches. 18 inches of equivalent water content. What that's telling you is if you took all of the snow at that particular location where it's shaded in purple, melted all the snow down into water, you would be standing in water that's 18 inches deep. In other words, a foot and a half. Now that's, foot and a half maybe doesn't seem like a whole lot of water to you, maybe it does, but when you take a foot and a half and spread it out over all of those higher elevations of the Sierra, there's a lot of water up there. In particular, there's one spot right here in the central Sierra, directly east from the Bay Area, in fact, directly east from San Francisco, where you can see the snow water equivalent is the highest. Right in through here, see this patch? When you come in for a closer look at that, because that just happens to be Yosemite National Park, directly east of the city of San Francisco. But in terms of water supply, much more importantly, that's also where Hetch Hetchy Reservoir is, the water supply famously for the city of San Francisco. You can actually see the drainage on here for the Tuolumne River. Can you see it right there? There's a river drainage going through the mountains, and you can see the higher slopes of the Sierra here, those highest peaks, are where you've got the highest concentrations of stored water content right now. By the way, that's Yosemite Valley right there, if you're into this kind of thing, but I digress. A real pretty view, not only to see how the Sierra looks for snow, but to also understand why Hetch Hetchy Reservoir is situated so perfectly to be a water source for the city of San Francisco. Look at all that water there. Now, we've got much more snow to come because as we enter into these final weeks of 2021, Mother Nature has given us a big gift, a almost semi-permanent area of low pressure set up off the coast for about a 6 to 7 day period. That's like semi-permanent in areas of low pressure setting up off the coast anyway. That was hugely important because that allowed storms to continue to drop snow on the Sierra going into these last weeks of December, going all the way up to December 27th. This is new snow in addition to what we just looked at. It's almost doubling what was there should this come together. And as we go through these last few weeks, obviously, we'll be watching this come together in real time. That brings us to January 1st, which is the start of the season for when we start measuring the snowpack. The first official snowpack measurement comes out on January 1st. That will be news in the coming days. No doubt, very good news. We've done pretty nicely for ourselves in terms of the all-important snowpack in the Sierra for this year. We'll have to see how it plays out. April 1st is the most important snowpack survey. We're still several months from that, but we certainly got a great head start thanks to a very active December. All right, that's this week's Weather Extra, having a little bit of fun with snow. Paul Hagen will be back in next week with another one.